Lessons of Liberalism, Times of Challenge and Change. Karl Marx was a philosopher who saw the abuse of workers under liberalism. He created an idea called communism, or scientific socialism, that would establish equality among all citizens. People who supported his beliefs were called Marxists. Utopian socialism is an ideology invented by Sir Thomas More. An essential belief to the society is that the bourgeoisie should be responsible for the well-being of the proletariats. It was a response to the appalling conditions of workers in the factory system. Robert Owen actually created his own utopian society called New Lanark that proved to Europe that profit could be made even if the business took care of its workers. Fabian socialism was founded in 1884 by 9 people. The name Fabian comes from a Roman general, Fabius Maximus, who is known for his delaying tactics. Their mascot is also a tortoise. Some key beliefs of Fabianism are evolutionary tactics over revolutionary tactics, which means socialism should be achieved in multiple stages instead of one, and permeation, which means infiltrating institutions, parties, and parliament in order to spread their ideology. Democratic socialists believe in economic security and protecting the environment while letting individuals remain free. This is referred to as positive freedom. Some countries that exercise democratic socialism are Sweden, Finland, and Norway. Luddites were a movement of people before and during the Industrial Revolution that were supposedly led by Ned Ludd, who lived in Sherwood Forest and organized the attacks. Ludd was referred to as General Ned Ludd or King Ludd. However, Ned Ludd is a fictitious character who served to antagonize authorities. Luddites frequently destroyed machines and sent threatening letters in an attempt to expose and aggravate the employers who mistreated workers. Several manufacturers used machines in a fraudulent and deceitful manner and ignored standard labor practices. Luddites were concerned about being replaced by more efficient machines and fought to keep their jobs as well as for better pay. Chartism was a movement started by the working class that petitioned for political rights and influence for the working class. Their name came from the People's Charter that listed the 6 aims of their movement. These aims were a vote for all men over 21, the secret ballot, no property qualification to become an MP, payment for MPs, electoral districts of equal size, and annual elections for Parliament. The Chartists petitioned the Parliament 3 times, in 1839, 1842, and 1848. All 3 petitions were rejected. Edmund Burke promoted a society that was largely contrary to the new ideas that were being evolved in his time. He believed that people were corrupt and irrational, and it would be dangerous to allow complete freedom or make everyone equal. He supported the American Revolution, but saw the French Revolution as an upset to the balance of society. His ideology is still around today and is called classical conservatism. The Haymarket Riot was a protest of the killing and wounding of several workers at a strike the day before. When police showed up to disperse the rally, a bomb was thrown which killed 7 policemen and 1 bystander. 8 men were eventually convicted without solid evidence and sentenced to death. This event of 1886 is a symbol of unfair labor practices. Before 1834, the upper and middle classes were taxed to take care of the poor. However, every year the cost of looking after the poor was steadily climbing. In 1834, the new poor law was introduced, and it ensured that the poor were housed, clothed, and fed, and children would receive some schooling. In return, the poor would work for several hours a day in the workhouse. Many riots broke out because of the abuses and mistreatment in the workhouses. In 1888, Annie Besant discovered the working conditions and pay of women working at the Bryant and May match factory. Women were paid little, often fined, and suffered from Fossey jaw. Besant immediately jumped to do something about it, such as writing in her newspaper, boycotting the factory, and forming the Match Girls Union. The strike forced the company to alter some systems before the women would come back to work. Once the strike was a success, Annie Besant continued to campaign against the use of phosphorus. The Salvation Army created a factory that used only red phosphorus and paid its employees twice the amount that the Bryant and May match factory did. Eventually, the Bryant and May match factory discontinued the use of yellow phosphorus. Jacob S. Coxey faced financial issues during the Panic of 1893. Coxey formed a group of protesters against the federal government's failure to assist the American populace. He marched from Massillon, Ohio to Washington, D.C., and unfortunately was refused help. The March of Coxey's army demonstrates the desire of Americans for their government to be more involved. The Triangle Shirtwaist Factory fire was an incident that demonstrated the lack of precautions in companies. When the fire started, there was no sprinklers, the fire escape broke, the one working elevator managed only 4 trips, and the exits were locked from the outside. 144 people died in 18 minutes. This incident served as a model for state and national workplace safety. Classical liberalism created many challenges, such as the abuse of workers and the wealth gap. Liberalism begins to shift in response to this turmoil.